Find somebody who loves you as much as James Cameron loves water. Actually, you know what? Maybe find somebody who loves you about half as much as James Cameron loves water. You want to keep the relationship healthy.
It's wonderful.
Avatar The Way of Water is a $350 million 3-hour-plus fantasy epic about moving your family to California and having to embrace surfer culture, bro. It's also a movie about how cool it would be to have a whale outcast as a best friend who spoke to you in papyrus subtitles. The Way of Water picks up several years after the end of Avatar, following the vanquishing of humanity from the planet Pandora. Jake and Neytiri have started a family together and are living an idyllic existence. This is thrown into chaos when spaceships drop out of the sky, carrying a new wave of troops and colonists. Jake and Neytiri are forced to take their children into hiding, fleeing to Pandora's aquatic water tribe. Also, somehow Colonel Miles Quaritch has returned. Even more than the original Avatar, The Way of Water is a collection of director James Cameron's pet themes and interests. It's a wet, new-age, pop-Christian environmentalist fable about how the military is inherently evil. Those who dismiss the original as Dances with Smurfs are unlikely to be won over by a movie that invites overt comparisons to Waterworld. This is not a movie that can survive any contact with cynicism. There is, to put it frankly, something endearing in this. It's very clear watching the movie that Cameron has thought very carefully and very precisely about this fictional world that he's created, and the film perhaps functions best as a travelogue of a place that doesn't exist. Cameron uses 3D and variable frame rate effectively, creating a sense of majesty and wonder to this space-age adventure. Cameron has obviously spent the better part of 2 decades imagining life on this alien world. One might wish that he spent half as much time imagining the inner lives of his characters. Cameron builds The Way of Water as a broad and accessible story about fatherhood, and one curiously lacking in specificity or insight. His characters are wonderful visual creations, but even that is only skin deep. The problem is compounded with the movie's female characters. Cameron has a long and rich history of writing compelling female leads, like Sarah Connor, Ellen Ripley, and even Rose from Titanic. Neytiri wasn't a particularly complex or nuanced character in the original Avatar, but that movie at least gave her things to do. The Way of Water reduces her to shouting and chiding. Kate Winslet, the most prominent addition to the movie's cast, is completely wasted in an underwritten role. By the way, Kate Winslet has almost been drowned by James Cameron more times than she's won an Oscar. Still, there's an infectious earnestness to The Way of Water. This is a movie that takes itself very seriously, and isn't at all concerned that the internet might be snickering about it behind its back. After decades of watching blockbusters undermine themselves in a race to make the joke before, insert YouTube channel here, can, it's refreshing to watch a movie that plays its beats uncompromisingly straight. This is perhaps most obvious at the climax. A lot of critics have rushed to label a third act a movie's are back moment, and it's easy to understand why. The third act of The Way of Water is cleanly constructed, coherently edited, and visually well organized. These are not a given in a cinematic landscape where the third acts of franchise films are often farmed out to second units and hacked together in post-production. In The Way of Water, it's always clear where the characters are in relationship to one another, and what each party wants in a given confrontation. The spatial geography is explained, the framing is clear. It's not the best blockbuster climax in a year that also gave us Nope, The Northman, The Batman, Prey, and even Top Gun Maverick, but it is a welcome reprieve in a year that also gave us Jurassic World Dominion, Wakanda Forever, and The Gray Man. To his credit, Cameron even uses 3D in a way that is truly immersive and effective. The Way of Water is a curiously old-fashioned kind of blockbuster, one elevated by special effects that are literally out of this world. However, the movie's characters and narrative are unfortunately all at sea. It's fine, but it's hardly earth-shattering. Avatar The Way of Water is in cinemas now.